We're going to Vegas, boys. Anyway, guys, welcome back to the channel. It's the States FC. In today's video, I'm going to be discussing how the U.S. men's national team should line up against Mexico on Sunday in our Gold Cup final. But real quick, before I do that, I'm going to just have a few takeaways from my game against Qatar yesterday in a game that we squeaked out, but we got the win, and that's all that matters. So anyway, let's get into it. So my first takeaway from this game is, one, it was very clear that it was a tale of two halves. Qatar dominated the first half by a large margin and should have been up by two goals off, you know, just two deflected shots. But had it not been for Matt Turner, we'd probably go down 2-0 and probably lose that game. So Matt Turner has stood on his head this entire tournament, continued to do that yesterday and saved us once again. Secondly, like I said, going back to the tale of two halves, Berhalter said something at halftime because something clicked and instantly that second half was ours. Like Qatar had the first half. Qatar literally had nothing besides a penalty kick in the entire second half. So well done to turning the things around. Last thing I want to say is when we did get the ball in the final third, it just fell apart. Like we couldn't go anywhere and have a lot of quick little play in the final third, but it just would really break down. We could not get anything. And last up, the poor counter pressing. I saw so many times in the game where we would counter press. Kellen Acosta would just fly into there trying to press and win the ball back, but we would just get played through way too easy. And against a team like Mexico, no way in the heck is that going to work. They're going to play right through us with ease. So we have to be careful with that going into the Mexico game. But anyway, not an easy team in Qatar. That is the Asian Cup champions. Like, that is one of the best teams in Asia. And this is our C team. So this is actually a pretty solid win. But anyway, we got the job done. May not have been pretty, but anyway, we're in the Gold Cup final and they're not. So that's what I'll say. All right, so moving on offense, who should start? Sam Vines at left back. That's pretty clear. Not George Bello, not Shaq Moore. Sam Vines was okay yesterday, not great, but he's just been the most consistent this entire tournament. Miles Robinson, again, our most consistent defender this entire tournament, stood on his head once again, was absolutely fantastic yesterday. James Sands had a bit of a stinker, but he's been pretty good this entire tournament, and I'm pretty confident he'll bounce back, and he's better than any of the options that we have. At right back, I'm going to throw Reggie Cannon into the mixer because he's played against Mexico before in his professional career, twice actually, and done quite well. So Reggie Cannon, only 23, but super experienced when he came into the game yesterday, brought a lot of energy and enthusiasm in the final third. So I need to see Reggie Cannon at the right back spot against, he may be going against Tecatito, which is going to be a tough test for him, but I think that he can do it. All right, so moving on to the midfield, Kellen Acosta at the six. He was, again, fantastic yesterday for the most part, had a few giveaways, not the best when counter-pressing, but, Kellen Acosta is one of the big reasons why we are here. Continue to get the start. No one else really can play at the six like he can. In those eights, I think Gianluca Busio had a good game yesterday, continued to do that, hopefully against Mexico. We need technical players that can beat Mexico's press, that can play through it, get the ball forward, and aren't going to be sloppy when they're on the ball. Same goes for Eric Williamson. I think Sebastian Legit has been ran out this entire tournament, has not looked good at all the past two games. So I think Eric Williamson is a must start for the next game. When he came into the game, it just seemed like we had more control in the midfield. He is very, very technical and can really ping the ball around. So I think Busio and Williamson is the ideal dual eights, guys that can control the ball and can play through Mexico's press without losing the ball poorly like some of our other guys that we have in camp. So I think this is the best midfield group, and this midfield group is going to have to work because Mexico is a team that's going to want to possess you, play you to sleep. But if this midfield group can be tough, put in a good tackle here and there, be a little bit chippy, I think they can frustrate Mexico and do the job. So anyway, on to the front three. All right, so four is Matthew Hoppe. The left wing, again, was really, really good yesterday. I don't know how he did it, but he played this perfectly weighted ball to Daryl Dike, which he should have finished. Matthew Hoppe, you can see how technical he is, a graduate of the Barca Residential Academy. I think Matthew Hoppe he's only 20 years old, but he just looks so good at left wing and playing out of position. He's a must start. I'm sure he's going to have a lot of fire in the game against Mexico. He plays with so much passing. When he came off yesterday, he was yelling at Greg Berhalter. That's something I like to see. He doesn't want to be taken out of the game. He wants to be on the field helping his team win the game. Up top, I think you have to go with Giassi Zardes. Daryl Dike had a bit of a stinker yesterday, and I just think by and large that's due to a shoulder injury. You can tell he does not look anywhere near 100%. He's just running around with his shoulder kind of dangling around, and he just hasn't played good the past couple games, so I think you have to give it to Zardes. I don't think Zardes necessarily has done a whole lot in the games that he's played off the bench in the knockout round. Yes, he scored the goal, but he's not super influential. But I think if you're trying to beat a team like Mexico and their high press, a guy like Giassi Zardes, his off-the-ball running could be a very, very big tool in this game. the right wing, I have Shaq Moore. He's played there for his club before. It's not like he's going to be playing in a brand new position, you know, and we're likely going to be doing a lot of defending in this Mexico game. So I think Shaq Moore coming back, helping defend Reggie Cannon, and can be really, really good in transition, picking out that pass and getting forward. I just think in order to really balance the field and help out when we're sitting back and bunkering down against actually a pretty good Mexico team, I just think this is the best front three that can run off the ball, you know, create some things when we get down there and potentially put, you know, just put the ball in the back of the net. Like, that's something that we need to do tomorrow. We're not going to get a whole lot of chances, so when the opportunities come, we have to be clinical. Anyway, guys, that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please let me know what your ideal starting 11 would be. This game against Mexico is going to be tough because this is our C team, but I'm really proud of the boys. They've done really well this entire tournament, putting a lot of effort. Might not be our best team, but it just shows how much depth that we have in this Mexico team. It's a very, very good team, so we cannot sleep on them. I think they are the favorites, but, you know, it's USL treat. Anything can happen. You know, it's going to be chippy. It's going to be fun, but I'm all for it. Anyway, as always, thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.